Namaste students, and welcome to one more session of poetry class. In the previous session, we had taken up a poem called Unfolding Bud by Naoshi Koriyama. We learned that there is a process of understanding a poem which is similar to an unfolding of a water lily bud. Today we will take up another touching poem. But before that, let me ask you one question. Do you all like animals and birds? I know the answer is yes. But can you imagine a world without them, without animals, without birds? I know it is very difficult to live without them. In today's poem, The Lost Dances of Cranes by Juliet Wilson will take up an environmental issue like this. The Lost Dances of Cranes by Juliet Wilson. Juliet Wilson is a British historian, curator, and keeps a museum and other collections. She is also an independent scholar who conducts scholarly research outside university and traditional academia. She is specializing in Francisco Goya, a Spanish painter, and also in Edouard Manet, a French painter. She studied in Edinburgh, where she lives. She has had over 50 poems published in UK Poetry Journal. She is popular as a great environmentalist. When asked what inspired her to write, she said that nature and environmental issues are two of her biggest influences for writing poetry. So let's go ahead and read the poem. The Lost Dances of Cranes is written in 11 lines, and every line has a message to convey. Your fields are empty now, only your ghosts dance, while cranes of another kind dance cities into being. All that remain of you are a fading crackle of your energy and some grainy video footage that people in the new cities will watch to marvel at the wonders the world once held. The poem begins with the sentence, "Your fields are empty now." Here the poet is describing a bird called whooping cranes. The poem mourns the absence of these water birds. The speaker is addressing this crane, which are water birds. It is in the verge of extinction because of drastic reduction of wetlands due to the human desire to expand land used in building high-rise apartment blocks. The word crane is mentioned in the title, and the whole poem talks about it. But you may ask me, what is a whooping crane? This is the bird Juliet Wilson is talking about. Whooping crane is the tallest North American bird in an endangered crane species named for its whooping sound, along with the sandhill crane. It is one of only two crane species found in North America. The whooping crane's lifespan is estimated to be 22 to 24 years in the wild. After being pushed to the brink of extinction, it has gone down to 25 years, and there are two captive whooping cranes by 1941. Let's go to the poem. Only your ghosts dance. Dancing is a part of mating rituals of whooping cranes. Since so many birds have been lost, they no longer do their elegant dances on their fields. Only the ghostly memories of their graceful movements remain, because it has been transformed into buildings like this. If you look at the picture, There is no greenery around, and there are so many buildings that Whooping Crane has no place to rest. It is loaded with so many buildings. Then Wilson is telling that while cranes of another kind dance cities into being, there are definitely cranes, but it is of different kind. In the past, the dance of the beautiful crane used to enchant those who could witness it. Now, the same fields, one sees only the mechanical crane like this, which are made of metal, occupying a large area, and only the movements of the crane machine can be seen now. Here the dance doesn't yield eggs and more birds, but rather the cities that are ironically destroying the birds. The speaker seems to indicate that the near extinction of cranes is due to man's desire to build structures and buildings on the very home of the cranes, namely the wetlands where the crane could survive. If you could see that these cranes are busy loading and unloading and obviously cutting down all the trees and making this world into a concrete jungle. So after all this, what is remaining now? All that remain of you are a fading crackle of your energy and some grainy video footage. If you can see, there are some people who are looking at the picture of whooping cranes on a video, and they are amazed, astonished, almost shocked. By using the word you, the poet personifies the birds. The birds are fading quickly, and the poet mentions what we have now, that is memories and video. The word all that remains in the fifth line indicate that very little is left of the cranes, and the words fading and grainy tell us that those remains are in very poor condition. So here people are enjoying the beauty of nature in their houses, inside the four walls. Instead of going out and having a personal experience, they are enjoying the pictures on the videos. And look at this. Here people are in their homes. Looks like a living room. They are not talking to each other, but actually looking at the picture. The stanza which I had read sets up the next stanza with the specific things it mentions. That people in the new cities will watch to marvel at the wonders the world once held. This stanza captures an essential irony of modern living. We who live in cities think that we are getting the real thing by watching nature videos. In fact, a video is a worse than poor substitutes for the actual birds. It is worse because it fools us. It fools us into thinking that we are fully appreciating the natural beauty of our world through nature documentaries. People marvel at the dance of the cranes, but this image is one of the past. Now look at the birds here dancing. Look at the magnificent beauty. But this image is one of the past, when the birds used to arrive in due season to breed. Although the city dwellers marvel at nature, their fascination remains superficial, and they do not feel as connected to nature as the speaker, because they have not had a first-hand experience with birds. They may miss the videos, but will not be as deeply affected as the speaker. This is the whooping dance, a picture of two birds dancing, a magnificent, a marvelous sight to see. So students, would you like to Look at the elegant, graceful movements of these birds. So let's be ready to watch. Greatly inspired by the graceful movements of these birds. Did you hear the whooping sound? So unique, and you must have heard it for the first time. Wilson, through this poem, brings out a metaphor. The bird's dance represents the beauty of nature, while the movements of the mechanical cranes represent the destruction of this beauty. Through this poem, Wilson also expresses an irony by saying that people who are responsible for the destruction of the environment mourn its loss while doing nothing to restore it. I hope this poem has influenced you. I encourage you to value all the creatures around you as they are also a part of this environment as we are. Thank you for joining. Stay home, stay safe, continue learning.